Dear students, now let's study Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, which is one of the most important concepts in the topic of electromagnetic induction. This law states that due to relative motion between a magnetic field and a conductor, we can also consider that if there is a conductor or a closed coil, in both cases it will happen. So, due to relative motion between a magnetic field and a conductor of coil, if magnetic lines are cut, that means if relative motion is such that between magnetic field and a conductor or coil, if magnetic lines are cut or total magnetic flux, and this or implies this one and same thing, because total magnetic flux changes through a coil. That means whenever lines are cut, the total magnetic flux which is associated with the coil will change. We can say an EMF is induced in the conductor or coil, and this phenomena is called electromagnetic induction. So, electromagnetic induction is basically induction of an EMF in a conductor or a coil. When a total magnetic flux through the coil changes or magnetic lines are cut, and it will be certainly due to a relative motion between magnetic field and a conductor or a coil. Here we can also state about this induced EMF, that's important here, that the magnitude of induced EMF is equal to the rate at which flux associated over the conductor or coil changes, or we can say the rate at which flux is being cut. So, here we can write, if mathematically we can also express it like f n time dt, total flux change or cut by the conductor or coil is d phi. So, here we can write the magnitude of induced EMF. This E we can write as mod of d phi by dt. Here I have taken the modulus because the flux may increase or decrease. Depending on that, the value of d phi by dt may be positive or negative. So, the value of EMF will be magnitude of rate of change of flux. And later we'll study that the direction of this induced EMF always opposes the flux change. This we are going to discuss soon in form of another law called Lenz's law. And in that law, we'll study that the direction of this EMF always opposes the flux change. So, if we remove the modulus sign, we can always write the value of E, we can write as minus of d phi by dt. And here this negative sign signifies that the direction of this EMF is always opposite to the rate of change of flux.